Hello guys, welcome to second class of maximum minimum for function of two variables. In the first class, we discuss what are the measures or what are the steps I have to follow, what are the working rule I have to follow to find out maximum minimum for function of two variables. Here all written the board, examine the function. What's the function they given? F of x, y equals x to the power of 4 plus y to the power of 5 minus 2 into x minus 5 whole square for extreme values. Extreme values means finding a maxima and minimum value of that is nothing but extremities or extreme values. Okay. Now here, what given here, first you write down given. Okay. F of x, y equals x to the power of 4 plus y to the power of 4. Minus 2 times of x minus y whole square. Okay, whole square. This is a given function. Now, first try to find out first order partial derivative. What are the independent variables here? X and y. If I differentiate partially with respect to x, is nothing but fx or dou f by dou x. With respect to x, which is constant? Y is constant. Only that is a new concept. The rest of thing is just like ordinary. With respect to x, what we get actually 4x cube into derivative of x with respect to x1. With respect to x, y is constant. What is derivative of constant is 0. 2 into, but x minus y whole square involving x and y. First you find out derivative of the power. 2 into x minus y into derivative of x minus y with respect to x is 1. Simplify that. What we get actually? 4x cube minus 4 into x minus. Next, similarly, I have to find out which value fy. With respect to y, which is constant? X is constant. Therefore, this is 0. 4 into y cube, derivative of y to the power of 4 with respect to y. Again, you come to this term. X minus y is involving both x and y. It's not a constant with respect to x, with respect to y. Minus 2 into what is derivative of x minus y whole square with respect to y? 2 into x minus y into what is derivative of x minus y with respect to y? 0 minus 1. Now finally we get 4x cube. Actually now minus into minus, what we get actually? Plus. Because you're having minus sign, minus into minus plus 4x minus y. Okay. This is y cube, not x cube, y cube. After that, what we are going to do, equal to 0 means fx is equal to 0 and fy is equal to 0. Equal to fx and fy equal to 0. Fx is equal to 0 means what actually? 4x cube minus 4 into x minus y. You already find out, you already know that what is my fx equal to 0. And also 4y cube plus what actually 4 times of x minus y equal to 0. Observe carefully these two equations. 4 is a common, divide 4 is a non-zero value, dividing throughout by 4. X cube minus of, suppose you multiplied by minus sign, actually suppose you multiplied by minus sign, what we get actually don't confuse, okay. I'm going to write x minus y equal to 0, first dividing throughout by 4, and then y cube plus x minus y equal to 0, okay. Suppose you multiply this equation by minus, take it minus and inside, what we get actually minus x plus y. This is the one equation for fx is equal to 0. Fy is equal to 0, what's the equation? Y cube, okay. Y cube plus x minus y. What I'm going to do here, I told number of times while explaining maximum minimum for function of two variables, it's not easy to find out the critical values. Here I want to find out pair of critical points carefully at evaluate. Finding critical points vary from one function, one problem to another problem. After once you get fx and fy equal to 0, based on that we are going to find out carefully all possible pair of critical points. See, can't find out directly because involving both x and y. What I'm going to do in this problem, now I'm going to add these two. Once you add these two, what happen? X and y cancel. Once you add these two, what we get actually, x cube. Yes, once you add that, we get x cube plus y cube. What happened? Plus x and minus x plus y minus y is cancel. We get x cube plus y cube. You already know that why I did like that. You already know that what is a cube plus b cube. Alternative form of a cube plus b cube is nothing but a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. This formula you already know that in high school level itself. Once you simplify this, this also give rise what actually a cube plus b cube. A cube plus b cube can also be written as just like x cube plus y cube can also be written as x plus y into x square minus xy. A and b are nothing but x and y plus y square equal to 0. Now this is a way I to convert the product of two factors and then equal to 0. Once you equal to 0, x plus y equal to 0. What's another one? X square minus xy plus y square is equal to 0. Okay. Now this implies we get x is equal to minus y or y is equal to minus x. Choice of you. We are going to neglect this equation. Suppose you take a quadratic equation in x. Suppose you take quadratic equation in x, or if you want to take is a quadratic equation in y, you solve that. You know what is a quadratic equation formula? Minus a plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Either you solve based on x or you solve based on y. Once you solve based on x means we get y. Suppose I to find out quadratic expression y, we get in terms of x. Once you give the different values of x for here, give the different values of y here, definitely we get a complex root. Now we get a complex root, therefore we are going to neglect this. Either you take a quadratic expression in x or y. Suppose you take x, we get a root in terms of x, so y. Suppose you evaluate based on y, we get in terms of x. Once you give the values of x or y, we get a pair of complex roots. Therefore, we are going to neglect. What's the thing? X is equal to minus y. Now, we are going to substitute x is equal to minus y either this equation or this equation. Okay. Now, in the equation, I'm going to take first equation, x cube minus x, or if you want to take second equation. In both the case, we get same pair of critical points. Now, put x is equal to, what about that? Or you have to take y is equal to minus x. Okay. X is equal to minus y. Instead of that, if you want to take what is that? Y is equal to minus x. Both are same. What we get? X cube minus x is equal to 0. That implies x cube minus 2x is equal to 0. That implies what's a common factor? X. X into x square minus 2 equal to 0. It's a cubic equation. How many roots are expecting? 4 roots. Therefore, x is equal to 0, one of the root. X square minus 2 equal to 0. Yes, that implies what is x square is equal to 2. That implies what is my x is nothing but plus or minus root 2. Finally, we get how many roots? 3 roots. 3 roots we get for x. What are the 3 roots? X is equal to 0 and then root 2 and also minus root 2. We get the corresponding y values. You know that, we know that y is equal to minus x. Okay. That if, therefore, x is 0, that implies y also 0. Correct? X is equal to what about that root 2? Yeah. Where I'm going to put y is equal to minus x. We get the corresponding y value. What is y value? Minus root. Okay. And then x is equal to minus root 2. That implies y is minus x, therefore minus into minus plus root 2. Finally, we get what are the critical points we get here? Now 0, 0. Yeah. For x is 0, y also 0, and then root 2 minus root 2, and what's another one? Minus root 2 comma root 2 are the critical points. Okay. Once you get critical points, how to proceed? You find out second order partial derivatives. You have first order partial derivatives. For your reference, I'm going to write in the right side corner, what is my fx? What is my fx value here? 4x cube. Yes. Suppose I to remove the bracket, what we get actually? Minus 4x of minus 4 into x minus y. Okay. What is my fy? Fy is nothing but 4y cube plus 4 into x minus y. Okay, fine. In the next step, what we are going to do here, now I have to find out second order partial derivatives. What are the second order partial derivative here? A is nothing but, A is nothing but actually, I'm going to take A is nothing but, if you want to use a different color of pen, I'm going to take A. What is my A is nothing but fxx. Means I have to differentiate twice partially with respect to x. Again, I have to differentiate this with respect to x. We get, again, y is constant. 12x square. Okay, fine. Minus 4 is a constant. What is derivative of x minus y with respect to x is 1. We get minus 4. This is my A value. Okay. Next, I want to find out B. B is nothing but what actually? Fxy or Fyx. Choice of you. Fxy means first you differentiate partially y and then with respect to x. Means you take fy, again differentiate partially with respect to x. With respect to x, which is constant? Y is constant. Therefore, this is constant. 4y cube is 0. 4 into what is derivative of x minus y with respect to x is 4. Okay, we get a constant. C. What is my C value? Fyy. Differentiate twice partially with respect to y. You, this is fy, again differentiate partially with respect to y, we get 12y square. With respect to y, x minus y, we get minus, plus into minus is minus, we get minus 4. These are the values for A, B, C. Next, instead of taking, I'm going to write it your simple way how to verify all three critical points. I'm going to write a table. Instead of taking each and every point, I have to verify what happened A, B, C and A square, A, C minus B square. Better I have to write it everything on the table. Then easy to write everything in the table. Okay. Yeah. Just observe this. Yeah. In the table, first one, I'm going to write this is a points. Okay, I'm going to write this as a points. Points, I'm going to write it in the row wise. How many points you have? You have 3 points. 0, 0, root 2, minus root 2, minus root 2, comma root 2. Okay. And then, if you want to take addition, I want A. What is my A value? 12 x square minus 4. What's the value B? Is 4. What is my C? It's nothing but 12 x square, this is actually, the both are thing is minus 4, 12 y square, not x square, y square minus 4, okay. And also, I want to take addition based on AC minus B square, right? Okay, therefore, I'm going to write extra one row, and also write another row is nothing but conclusion. Okay, fine. Now, what is my AC minus B square? Based on AC minus B square only, I have to decide. Next is conclusion. Okay. Fine. This is the way I have to write the table. Yeah, how many points you have? 3 points. Okay, fine. And take first point. What's the first point? 0, 0. Now I have to put 0, 0. What happened? Put 0. Now what we get A is minus 4. Okay. Yeah, even though put 0 or anything, B is a constant, we get a constant only. Put Y is 0, what we get is minus 4. AC minus B square. What is my AC minus B square? Minus 4 into minus 4. Minus 4 into AC. AC minus B square. minus 4 into minus 4 minus 4 square. What we get actually 16 minus 16. What we get? 0. Therefore, AC minus P square is 0. AC minus P square is 0. What I told, conclusion is further investigation is required. That much you have to write. Required. Okay. Okay, fine. Next point. What's the next point? Root 2 comma minus root. Okay. What happened? Root 2 comma minus root 2. What is root 2 whole square 2? 12 2s are 24. 24 minus 4. 20. 20 is positive, greater than 0. Okay, fine. And next, this is any value is 4 only because it's a constant. Minus 2 root 2 whole square, what we get actually? Root 2 only because minus root 2 whole square is 2. Again, this is also 20. And then AC minus B square. AC in the second case, AC minus B square. What is my AC? 20 into 20, what we get? 400. Minus B square, what is B square is? 16. What we get? 384. 384 is positive. Yeah, AC minus B square is positive. There are two things. Now take addition based on A. A is positive. AC minus B square is positive. A is positive. Then I have to write at this point the function is minimum. Yes? Minimum, yeah, minimum, okay. I'm not complete the conclusion because another root also just similar to that, minus root 2 comma plus root 2. There also we get same thing because minus root 2 whole square, what happened? 2. We get 20. This also positive. Now here 4. This also we get 20. This also 384. In both the case, we get same conclusion. Therefore, instead of writing for 1, into combining both, I'm writing conclusion based on both the roots. Okay. Yes. Minimum at both the points. Both the points, you know what are the points. Root 2 and minus root 2 or minus root 2 comma root 2. Then you take any one of the point and the corresponding minimum value is. How to find out minimum value? I told number of times. You take the given function, just substitute any one of the critical point. What is that? X to the power of 4 plus y to the power of 4 minus 2 into x minus y whole square. You take this, substitute the value, either you take root minus root 2 comma root 2 or root 2 comma minus root 2. In both the case, we get the value is minus 8. Just you substitute. Don't expecting that's also do it on the board because just you substitute. Keep in mind, either you substitute root 2 comma minus root 2 or root 2 minus root 2 comma root 2. In both the case, we get same answer. We get same minus 8 only. Okay. This is a way I have to solve the problem. This is a way I have to take a decision for the extremities. For the given function is a function of two variables. I'm showing entire problem in one screenshot. Yeah. Just a minute. Yeah, you do one thing. It's not possible I have to showing entire problem in one screenshot. Better I have to take two parts. Okay, then yeah, easy to, yeah. Yeah, now I'm showing entire the problem in screenshot. Okay, fine. This is one screenshot. Okay. And next, I move to the next problem. This is another screenshot. Choice of you, please. I'm showing both the things once again. Anybody want a screenshot, you please take it. And then move to the this one. Yeah. Okay, fine. Now move to the next problem. Once you clear this flow chart, no, then easy to solve the problem. It's not necessary to explain all the problems on the board. Okay, fine. I'm sharing my notes in where actually in e contents e section. You please go through that. Okay, I'll move to the next problem. I think it's familiar. It's clear how to proceed. How many problems I solved on the board is not important. How much is clear is very very important. Therefore, move to the next problem, okay? Second problem. In the second problem, examine for minimum and maximum values for in gray wall textbook they taken cos. But here I'm doing in the on the board sign. You refer Grewal, same problem, but they taken instead of sign is cos. Sin of sin x plus sin y into sin of x plus y. Okay, fine. Now here, first you take the what is my f of x y? What is my f of x y? First, you see, it's not mentioned f of x, y. It's clear it's a function of x and y. I'm going to assign these three terms must be f of x, y. Sin x plus sin y plus sin of x plus y. Okay, fine. Now, first you, as usual, first you find out first order partial derivatives. What are the first order partial derivatives now? Fx. What is my differentiate partial with respect to x, which is constant? Y is constant. What is derivative of sin x is cos x. This is 0. But it's a function of both. Therefore, you can't keep the constant. What is derivative of sin? Cos of x plus y into derivative of x plus y with respect to x is 1. Okay. And also find out fy. What is my fy? With respect to y, x is constant. Therefore, first term is 0, cos y. Again, it's a function of both x and y. Derivative of sin is cos of x plus y into derivative of x plus y with respect to y is 1. After that, equal to 0 means in the next step, what we are going to do, fx is equal to 0 and fy is equal to 0. That implies what is my fx? Cos x plus cos of x plus y equal to 0 and also cos y plus cos of x plus y equal to 0. Is it, I think it's clear. Now using these two equations, I'm trying to find out the pair of critical points, say x1, y1, x2, y2. I told vary from one problem to finding a critical points depends upon the equations of fx and fy after equal to 0. Okay. Now here you can't find out directly what I'm going to do here. I'm going to do the subtract. Once you do the subtract, cos of x plus y is cancelled. Okay. Subtract. Once you subtract, what happened? This is negative. This also negative. Okay. What we get actually? Cos x minus cos y, this is 0, cancelled, yeah, equal to 0. That implies cos x is equal to cos y. Cos x is equal to cos y, that implies what we get is equal, what's the thing? X is equal to y. Y is equal to x or x is equal to y. Choice of you. Observe carefully. Okay, either you take y is equal to x or x is equal to y. Cos x is equal to cos y, that implies x is equal to y. Either you substitute in the first equation or substitute in the second equation. Choice of you. Okay, I'm going to take second equation, this equation. Cos of cos y plus cos of x plus y equal to 0. That implies put x is equal to put y is equal to x, that implies what we get actually cos x plus cos of y is x, therefore x plus x is cos 2x equal to 0. That implies cos 2x must be equal to minus of cos x. Now, I think it's clear how we get this step. What I did, I just take a second equation, put y is equal to x, what we get, cos x plus cos 2x equal to 0. I shifted cos x in the right hand side, what we get, cos x must be equal, cos 2x must be equal to what actually, minus cos of x. Minus cos of x can also be written as, now I'm going to write, it's nothing but, what's the thing, cos of pi minus x. You know that, what is cos of pi minus theta? What is cos of pi minus theta is minus cos theta. Therefore, minus cos x can be written as what actually? Cos of pi minus x. That implies 2x must be equal to pi minus x. That implies 3x is equal to pi. That implies what is my x is equal to pi by 3. Yeah. We get only one value, x is equal to pi by 3. But you have x is equal to pi, x is equal to y, means y is equal to x. Therefore, if x is equal to pi by 3, that implies y is equal to x, that also is equal to pi by 3. What is my critical point here? This implies a pi by 3 comma pi by 3 is a critical point. Critical point of the given function f of x, y. Okay, it's a critical point. What's the next step? I want to find out derivative. Which derivative? Higher derivative. What is the higher derivative? I want to find out capital A, capital B, capital C. What is capital A value? You already know that this is my fx. This is nothing but what? My fx. This is nothing but what? Actually, fy. What is capital A fxx? Again, I have to differentiate partially this with respect to x. We get minus sin x. But again, this is not a constant involving both sine and cos. What is derivative of cos? Minus cos of x. What is derivative of cos is minus sine. Okay? Minus of sine of x plus y into derivative of x plus y with respect to y is 1. And also I have to find out what is my b. B is nothing but fxy. What is my fxy? Is nothing but you take fy, differentiate partially with respect to x on both sides. With respect to x, cos y is 0, but this is not 0, minus sin of x plus y into derivative of x plus y with respect to x is 1. Okay. Similarly, I have to calculate c. What is c? Fy by. You take second expression, this expression, differentiate again partially with respect to y. What we get? Minus sin y. Minus sin of x plus y into derivative of x plus y with respect to y is 1. These are the values of a, b, c. In this problem, we don't want a table. Why? Because we have only one critical point. See, whenever having more than one critical point, why should I have to write every step a, b, c repeated so many times? Better I have to construct the table. In the previous problem, we get three critical points. Here we have only one critical point. It's not necessary to construct the table. Find out directly at the point, at which point, at pi by 3, what happened? A, B, C. Pi by 3, comma pi by 3. What is A? A is nothing but sine of pi by 3 minus sine of pi by 3 plus pi by 3. What we get? Sine of 2 pi by 3. Now, what is sine pi by 3? Is nothing but, yeah, this is having a minus sign. Yeah, sorry, having minus. Okay. Minus sine of pi by 3 is root 3 by 2. Again, sine of 2 pi by 3 also root 3 by 2. Add these two, we get minus 2 into root 3 by 2. 2, 2 is cancelled, we get minus root 3. Similarly, I have to calculate b. What is my b at this point? Same point I am going to find out. B is, you know that this minus sine of 2 pi by 3. sine of 2 pi by 3, just now we know, I told root 3 by 2 means we have minus sign, therefore minus root 3 by 2. Similarly, I have to calculate C, minus same value, sine of pi by 3 minus sine of 2 pi by 3. Yeah, same value for A, what we get actually minus root 3. Yeah, not necessary to simplify, just similar to this, we get minus root 3. Now you calculate what happened A. See, observe, A is less than 0. Here. AC minus B square. What is my A? Minus root 3. What is my B? Minus root 3. Minus of minus root 3 by 2 whole square. We get 3 minus 3 by 4. 3 minus 3 by 4. 12, take LCM, 12 minus 3 is 9 by 4. 9 by 4 means positive. AC minus B square is positive and the A is less than 0. Now I'm going to write the function is having a, at this point, maximum value. Here, since AC minus B square greater than 0 and A is less than 0, what happened? Therefore, f of xy has a maximum value at maximum value at pi by 3 comma pi by 3. Yes? And the corresponding maximum value is actually how to find out maximum value. I told number of times, just substitute in the given function this critical point. What's the given function? Sine x plus sine y plus sine of x plus y. Okay, fine. F of pi by 3 comma pi by 3 is nothing but sine of pi by 3, yeah, plus sine of pi by 3 and then sine of 2 pi by 3. In each case, we get root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2, plus root 3 by 2. Now, what we get actually? 3 times root 3 by 2. It's the corresponding maximum value of the given function at the corresponding critical point. This is a way to find out extremity values, even though they are given trigonometric function. In the given function, is it okay? I think it's clear. You maybe get a confident how to find out maximum minimum for function of two variables. Already I explained based on the flow chart. I'm requesting everyone, you keep in mind that flow chart means before I'm going to wind up the maximum minimum for function of two variables, I have to recall the steps. What are the working rule? First, you take the given function f of xy. Find out the first order partial derivatives equal to 0. Carefully solve these equations. Find out carefully pair of critical points. Once you get your critical points, you find out fxx, fxy, fyy. Wherever convenient, choose fx is a, fxy is b, fxy, fyy is c. And then frame a expression ac minus b square. Take one by one. Suppose you're having more than one critical point, please may take it verification in the table. One first column is points, second first row is a points, second row is A, second B, C, AC minus B square, and last row is conclusion. Then you take point to point, find out ABC, and then verify AC minus B square. Suppose AC minus B square is greater than 0, immediately verify corresponding point what happened A. A is also greater than 0, then we say that function is having a minimum value. Suppose AC minus B square greater than 0, but A is less than 0, the function is having a maximum value at that corresponding critical point. Suppose AC minus B square itself is less than 0, function is neither maximum nor minimum. Suppose AC minus B square itself is 0, then you write simply that further investigation is required. This is a way to solve the problem for maxima minima for function of two variables. In the next class, I am going to explain how to solve Lagrange's undetermined multiplayers. Lagrange's undetermined multiplier is one of the method to find out the maximum or minimum value of the given function is involving more than two variables, and also they having some constraints. Constraints means conditions. The given function is involving more than one independent variables. Along with that, they given some constraints, means they given some conditions. How to find out? There we are using one of the method is called Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. Thank you very much for listening this problem. Okay, bye, see you and take care. Please come back in the next class. It's the last class for the module 2. Okay, bye, see you and take care.